Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to practically demonstrate how to execute Selenium automation scripts on Edge browser. So there are two ways we can do this. One is by downloading the Edge driver and setting the path in our Selenium automation code and thereby executing. Or in place of that, we can also use this WebDriver manager thing. I'll show you two ways. First of all, to get started, we need to create a Java project. I'll open my Eclipse IDE and here I'll create a new project. I'll prefer creating a Maven project, guys. So I will select new instead of Java project. I will select project so that, and here in this wizard, I will search for Maven. You'll get this Maven options. Expand this Maven folder, select this Maven project, click on next, click on next. Here I will search for, I'll filter this for Maven hyphen quick start hyphen, sorry, Maven hyphen archetype hyphen quick start. Like this, I will search for. Now select this org Apache Maven archetypes, Maven archetype quick start, and click on next. Here I need to, inside the artifact ID, I need to give the project name. Let's say I will give the project name as Selenium Edge Demo. Okay, Selenium Edge Demo is the project name I am giving. You can give any name. Here in the group ID, you can give any name, guys. I am giving demo. Here also, demo pack I am giving as a package name. This is just anything you can give. Here, project name should be given inside the artifact ID. And click on finish. Once this Maven project is created like this, expand this Maven project, expand this SRC test Java, expand this package, and under that, right click on this default created Java file and delete it. It's not required. In place of that, I'll create a new class. I'll name this class as demo class. You can name it anything. And I will select this option to auto-generate this main method code inside the demo class that we are creating. Now, inside the main method, we'll write some code, guys. The statement that we have to write first is WebDriver driver is equal to new Edge driver. Okay, we have to write this. We have to create an object for the Edge driver, guys, because we want to run our Selenium automation scripts on Edge browsers. So we need to create an object for Edge driver and assign it to the variable of the WebDriver. That's fine. Now, this project is not yet configured with Selenium, guys. So if it is not configured, when I hover the mouse on WebDriver, I will not get any import statements here. So how to do that? I need to configure first this project with the Selenium Java files. So for that, I will open this pom.xml file. Since it is a Maven project, I have the facility of putting the dependency tags of Selenium Java inside this pom.xml file. Open this pom.xml file, go to the dependencies. Okay, here you can see some dependencies, some existing dependency is there. You can remove that if you don't want. Inside this dependencies, we need to add the dependencies of Selenium Java. For that, open any browser and search for mvnrepository.com. And here in the text box field, search for Selenium Java, guys. And select Selenium Java. Okay, once you select Selenium Java, now go scroll down a bit and go with the latest stable version of Selenium Java, guys. Okay, here these are all the alpha versions. We should not be using alpha versions. So as per today's date, 3.141.59 is the latest stable version of Selenium Java. I'm going with this. I'll copy the dependency tags, right click copy, and I'll go to the pom.xml file of this project, and inside the dependency tags I will paste it and I will save it. Now this project will be automatically configured with Selenium Java. Now close this. Now hover the mouse on WebDriver. Now you are getting the import statement. You can import the WebDriver interface and you can also import the Edge driver class. That's fine. This is not enough, guys. Apart from providing this line, before this line, we need to set the path to Edge driver. Okay. We have to download the Edge driver and just set the path to this particular Edge driver. Fine. Because I was explaining, right? I will be explaining two ways. First way is downloading the Edge driver. So now we need to download the Edge driver and set the path here before this line. For that, we need to first download, right? So from where we can download, for that, simply go to the official website of Selenium, that is selenium.dev, guys. Once you go to this official website of Selenium, go to the downloads page and now scroll down until you see something like browsers. Click on the browsers and you'll see a lot of browsers here. Go with the Edge browser and click on documentation. It will take you to the Microsoft page. One Microsoft page from where you can download the Edge driver. But guys, from where I want to download, there are a lot of links here. Do I have to download this one or this one, this one? It's confusing, right? So very simple, guys. What we can do is, in your machine, first you need to open the Edge browser. Search for Edge. You'll get the Microsoft Edge browser displayed. And this Edge browser will be only available in the Windows 10, guys. From Windows 10, Microsoft guys are providing two browsers. Earlier, before Windows 10, only one browser used to be provided by Microsoft, that is iBrowser. But from Windows 10, they are providing two browsers, that is, from Windows 8.1, they are providing, okay, not from Windows 10. So Edge browser is being provided in the, generally, nowadays, everyone using Windows 10. So Edge browser will be available in the Windows 10. Now, the next step is to find out the version of this Edge browser version. Okay, we have launched the Edge browser like this, right? After this, once the Edge browser is launched like this, you need to click on the three dots here. As you can see on the right side of the Edge browser, you can see three dots, click on that, go to settings. In this Edge browser version, we are able to see these three dots and settings. Tomorrow, the process may change. The latest version of Edge browser may have these three dots somewhere or settings somewhere. We have to follow the same process, okay? The intention is to click on the three dots, go to settings, and thereafter, we need to click on some about thing. You see, somewhere you will see about Microsoft Edge is there here. In the future versions, maybe this about section may be in a different place. Don't worry, guys. The current Edge browser, I have the settings and about here. So just follow this if you are able to. Otherwise, find out like where exactly you can find this about Microsoft Edge thing. So inside this about Microsoft Edge thing, you will see the version of the Microsoft Edge. Can you see the version of the Microsoft Edge? It's up to date and the version is 85.0.564.51. This is a version, right? This is a version. So the Edge browser version should match with this versions. So here release 87 is there. It's not 87, right? Whatever we have is 85.0.564.51. So we have to go with the 85. In that, we have to go with 85.0.564.51. And also 32 bit or 64 bit. Let's find it out. So in the Edge browser, it's mentioned as 64 bit. This version with 64 bit. So we can go with any of this 32 bit or 64 bit, but we can actually use 64 bit, right? I prefer 64 bit. 64 bit Edge driver and 64 bit Edge browser version with the same version. This version and Edge driver version both are matching now. And also the 64 bit is also matching. Click on the 64 bit link. Instead of clicking all the other links, you just need to find the match, appropriate match, which is compatible with this version. This version should be matching with this version, guys. And also here 64 bit is there. So let's prefer 64 bit. Let's click on the 64 bit. It will download the Edge driver of this particular version, which is same as the version in our machine, same as the Edge browser version in our machine. Once it is downloaded, let's go to the folder where it got downloaded and right click on the zip file which got downloaded and extract here. Click on extract. It will be extracted, guys. Open the extracted folder, and inside the extracted folder you will find this driver.exe file. My MS means Microsoft, Edge driver.application means exe file. Copy this and go to the project. Inside the project, right click on the project and say new and create a folder known as drivers folder. You can give any name for this drivers folder. I am giving drivers. Under this drivers, paste it. Okay, whatever the downloaded and copied exe file is there, you are just pasting inside this drivers folder. Now this particular path, we have to set it here. How to set the path? For that we have to type system.setProperties. Okay, system.setProperty. Two things should be there, string key and string value. So inside the key, we have to type something like webdriver.edge.driver. This is a property we need to set. Okay, before directly opening the Edge browser using this statement, we need to set the path. Okay, we need to set the path to this particular property. We need to set this property with a path. Which property? Webdriver.edge.driver property. And we need to give the path of the Edge driver. So how to give the path of the Edge driver? This is edge driver.exe, which we have downloaded just now, right? right click on this driver.exe, select properties. Now here you can directly copy the full path and say paste it here. That's it. Now we have set the path. Now let's we are done with the setting the driver.exe file path, and also we have written this statement which will open the edge driver. After that, I will use the same driver object, driver.manage.window.maximize, I will say, and finally I will say driver.get. I'll open some URL here. Let's say I would like to open this URL of this website, that is tutorialsninja.com/demo. I'll copy this, I'll provide it here, and then I would like to enter some text into this search field. So for that, I will inspect the search box field, and this is the HTML code of the search box field, guys. It doesn't have any ID attribute, but it has some name attribute. So copy this search and go here and say driver.findElementby.name. Okay, by.name. Paste the name value of this search box field and say .sendKeys. Inside the search box field, I want to search for iPhone. Okay, that's it. This is some sample script, guys, which will open this application in the Edge browser, and it will type this iPhone text into the search box field once open. So this is the code I have written. So let's see whether this particular Selenium automation code will run on the Edge browser or not. So I did whatever that is necessary. Okay, let's run this. Right click run as Java application. So you see Edge browser is launching. It will maximize in some time, and it will open the application URL. It's working fine, guys. Okay, into the search box field, it has to type iPhone. Yes, it has typed. Looks like our script got successfully executed. We didn't get any exceptions. The script is working fine, guys. Okay, this is how we need to execute our Selenium automation scripts on Edge browser. But guys, I told you that I will be explaining another way. Here, the first way is downloading the Edge driver. Right, this way. So if you don't want to provide this line where you have downloaded the Edge driver and provided the path here, okay, this is not required now. Okay, I'm not providing the path of this Edge driver.exe here. Rather, what I'm going to do is here I would like to use something like WebDriver Manager instead. WebDriver Manager dot. It will not work for the first time because you see we have to import this WebDriver Manager. How to import this? For that again we need to go to MVN repository and go to this website and search for WebDriver Manager. Okay, search for this WebDriver Manager. You'll get this GitHub link, github.bonigarcia WebDriver Manager. Go to the latest stable version and copy this. Copy the dependency tags for Maven and go to the project, open the pom.xml file. So add the dependency tags like this. Now save this. Now this project will be configured with WebDriver Manager also. If you are configuring the project with WebDriver Manager, you don't have to download this Microsoft Edge driver.exe and provide the path here. Okay, it will make our job simple, guys, where you don't have to download the exe file and provide the path. Rather, you can simply configure this project with WebDriver Manager and simply write the WebDriver Manager, say dot. Here, instead of Chrome driver or Chromium driver, you have to select Edge driver. Okay, Edge driver. Dot, you have to say setup. That's it. This simple line is fine. Once you add the dependency tags for WebDriver Manager, you just need to add this line. You don't have to download any exe file. Okay, this is second way, guys. So let's see whether this particular script is working without providing the path to the driver.exe and with the help of the WebDriver Manager, can we achieve or not? Let's see. Right click, run as Java application. So it has to open the, you see Edge browser got opened. It will maximize in some time, and then it will navigate to the application and it will type iPhone text. It has typed. So this is the script. It got executed successfully. So guys, this is how we can write our Selenium automation code for executing our scripts on which browser? Edge browser. So that's it, guys. That's all about this session. Thank you all. Bye.